Always in My Heart by Tricia Long, Lida Lutton, and Jennie Lutton. This book is dedicated to all children and families whose lives have been impacted by the incarceration of a parent or loved one. Special thanks to our early readers and advisors who helped to create this book. This is a picture of my mom and me. I don't live with her anymore. I live with Jen and Dave now. They are my foster parents. Jen has red hair, and Dave has a bushy beard the same color as our dog Buddy. My mom is in prison. Sometimes people call it jail or a correctional facility, or they say she's incarcerated. Mom is there because she broke a law. Laws are rules that people have to follow to help keep everyone safe. Sometimes when grown-ups break a law, they have to spend time in prison. How long they have to stay there depends on what law they broke and how much harm they caused. After Mom broke the law, police officers came to our house to arrest her. They took her away in a police car. I was really scared. I wanted to go with my mom, but the police officers wouldn't let me. I had to stay with our neighbor until a social worker arrived. Social workers are people who find foster parents like Jen and Dave when kids can't stay with their own families. The social worker helped me pack a bag of clothes and things I wanted to take with me. She said I could take our plant from the kitchen window and wear Mom's sweater to snuggle up in. She told me Jen and Dave's house was only a few minutes away. Jen and Dave are nice, but I still miss my mom. She'll be in prison a long time, and I'll be all grown up when she gets out. Even though Mom broke the law and hurt someone, she's not a bad person. Sometimes good people make bad mistakes. My mom always said, "I love you to the moon and back." She taught me a song about stars and wishes, and every night at bedtime, we used to sing it. Before she went to prison, we did lots of fun things together. When it snowed, we built snow people with carrot noses. She taught me how to cut paper to make snowflakes and stars. She made the best peanut butter sandwiches. In prison, Mom has her own bed and a place to hang up the pictures I send her. She says she still sings our song about stars and wishes every night. I sing it too. Mom eats breakfast, lunch, and dinner with all the other women at tables in the cafeteria. I know that every time she puts ketchup on her food, she blows me a kiss. I do the same thing. We call them our ketchup kisses. They remind us of each other. Some of the women do jobs in prison, like washing dishes or cleaning floors. Some take classes, too. There's a TV they can watch, and a place where they play cards and read books. Sometimes my mom and I read the same book. People in prison can't leave the building on their own, but each day they get to go outside for a short time. Mom says she looks for four-leaf clovers in the grassy yard, and if she finds one, she's going to send it to me. Mom says she's okay in prison, even though she'd rather be home with me. She doesn't want me to worry about her. She sends me lots of letters with pictures she's drawn. I save them all in a special place. I wish I could talk to my mom on the phone whenever I want, but I can't. She doesn't have her own phone. All the moms have to share one phone. Calling from prison is expensive. Mom doesn't have much money. She tries to call me each month, but some months she can't. I feel disappointed when she doesn't call, but Dave and Jen remind me that she's still thinking about me. When something big or exciting happens in my life, Dave helps me write a letter and send Mom pictures so she can see what happened. We did that when I lost my first tooth and when I learned how to ride a bike. When we have a holiday, I make her a special card and send it with a picture of me. Every year around my birthday, I get to visit with Mom. It's a really long trip. When we get to the prison, we have to wait in line and go through a security check. We cannot bring anything inside with us. There are lots of other kids waiting to see their moms, too. I like knowing that I'm not the only kid with a mom in prison. Even though I don't like going inside the prison, I love seeing my mom. She hugs me and we buy a treat from the vending machine. She tells me how much she loves me and that she's so proud of me. She's surprised how much I've grown. In a few more birthdays, I'll probably be up to her shoulders. When our visit ends, she hugs me for a long time and says, "I love you to the moon and back, that far, my shining star." It's hard to leave the visit. I know Mom is okay in prison, but I wish she could come home with me. Sometimes I have really big feelings. Sometimes I feel sad. I wish she didn't have to be in prison so long. Sometimes I feel scared or lonely, and I wish she could be with me. Sometimes I feel really angry. I wish she had not broken the law. I mean, I know she wishes that too. Sometimes I feel embarrassed. Other kids talk about their moms. I don't want them to know about mine. When I have really big feelings, I can take some deep breaths to help myself feel better. I breathe in through my nose and blow the air slowly out of my mouth. Jen helped me make a pinwheel, and I like to watch as my breath spins it around. Sometimes I imagine my big feeling is like a leaf floating down a stream. I can wait for it to drift away. Big feelings don't last. Often I can let them go. Some drift away more quickly, and others may take a little longer. One of my friends has a dad who will be in prison for a long time, too. Sometimes we worry about things, but when we're having fun together, like when Dave takes us on a surprise adventure, we don't worry so much. Mom doesn't want me to worry about her. She wants me to be happy. Most of the time, I am. But sometimes, I just feel like crying. When Mom first went away to prison, I used to hide my tears because I wanted to be brave. Now I know that tears can help me to be brave, especially when my heart hurts. I have a counselor at school who helped me learn that big feelings aren't so scary when I share them. Now, when my heart hurts and I really miss Mom, I tell Jen. Sometimes, sitting with Jen on the porch swing helps me feel better. She puts her arm around me, and we watch the stars. Jen says, "We see the stars best on a dark night, but even during the day when we can't see them at all, they're still shining out there. It's the same with the people we love. You can't see your mom right now, but her love for you never stops shining. You are always in her heart." Mom is always in my heart, too. Look in the back for questions for discussion and suggestions for what to do when you have big feelings. There are also some ideas for what to do to help a child stay connected and how to speak to a child about these issues. Thank you for listening and enjoying the story with us.